Welcome back to Mo's Sports and this homecoming edition. The Mules football squad made history this past Saturday as they came back from a staggering 31-7 deficit with only 10:23 left to play against the Mavericks from Nebraska-Omaha.
The Mules scored an astonishing 27 unanswered points in under 10 minutes. The game concluded with an 85-yard drive with 58 seconds to play and no timeouts. Senior quarterback Eric Zerneski found record-setting receiver Jamoris Warren in the back of the end zone with only 4 seconds left in the game.
Hey, thanks a lot, Jonesy. We're visiting with Mules football coach Jim Sabota. Big win today over UNO, 34-31, coach. We're going to start with questions in the second half, and it all started, you're down 14-0. UNO has the football. Marlon Douglas, once again, a pick six to get your team on the board.
Yeah, and that gave us some. Because, you know, there just weren't a lot of things going our way, you know, in the game, you know, from, and some of them were self-imposed with the turnovers, but then there was a number of breaks and things, and, you know, it was just, we needed something, and by God, we got it again.
In the final 10 minutes of the game, you're down 31-7 with 10 to go. A lot of things had to go right, and it started with the touchdown, then the onside kick. Take us through the onside kick.
Well, it was perfectly executed. We had a couple of different options there, and Coach Jeter decided to go with the one that we saw, the little pooch and the roller, and those kids just, something you work on, just like, towards the end of the game with throwing the ball with their last plays, you know, those things you work on all the time, and then, you know, most, you can go a year or two and not even use any of them, and we used everything we had today.
You know, you get that onside kick to get the ball back, but then the defense gets you a couple three and outs. They get you the football back, too.
Right, and it's a tough spot to be in from their offensive standpoint, you know, because they want to run some time off, and, you know, how much do you throw the ball and how conservative are you and so forth. So you got a little bit of an upper hand because, you know, they're kind of conservative there. And when you can mix it up offensively, then, you know, they were pretty tough all day. So, you know, once again, you know, our guys are just finding a way to get it done. They may kill me in the process, but just so proud of them. And, you know, they just, you know, the credit goes to the players. They willed it to happen.
Everything went right in the final 10 minutes. The clock management was perfect. You went 12 plays, 85 yards, and 58 seconds without any timeouts for the game-winning touchdown. What was your thought process during that 58 seconds?
Well, we have what we call the last three plays. Actually, we have four plays that we do, and we actually just repeated them. And those are some of the completions. We started off the series with the thing that jump-started us, got us out of our, you know, backed up there was the great catch that Stu made, and we kind of saved that one. We felt like that was going to be there, but the wind was such a factor. I kind of wanted to be on the other hash when I did it, but that sort of got us going. And then we just went into a mode where, you know, those plays are automatic. They're called at the line of scrimmage, and, you know, the kids just did. They just made the plays.
Eric Zerneski, 38 of 57, 421 yards, three touchdowns. Your quarterback came through strong in the second half.
He did, and, you know, he's such a mentally tough kid, you know, bouncing back. He's just going extra effort, you know, there in the beginning, and, first drive, fumbled the ball down there. Going in and then overthrew a guy a little bit and tipped and got picked, and so he's fighting through some of those demons, and just couldn't be more proud of him.
Have you been part of a game like this before, being down like a score of 31-7, coming back in 10 minutes and win?
That was pretty dramatic. I've been blessed to be on the winning side of a lot of those. We had a national championship game where we were down 16 with 3.5 to play and got that thing into overtime and eventually won that. But it's about as good as it gets, what you saw today.
Coach, congratulations. It's a great win. Your team's playing with a lot of confidence with two regular season games left to go.
Thank you. Couldn't be more proud of our players.
All right, Coach.
Senior Cherneski out of the shotgun. Looks, fires, end zone. Touchdown! Central Missouri leads it 33-31 with 4 seconds to go.
Tied his school record with 14 receptions and also set a new single-season reception mark with 71. The senior from Scottsdale, Arizona also proved time and time again to be Cherneski's favorite target when the game is on the line.
For the first time in school history, the Mules are now 7-0 in league play and are currently ranked 9th in the latest AFCA poll. Their overall record now stands at 8-1, and they are ahead of Northwest Missouri State with only 2 games remaining in the regular season.
The Mules hit the road this Saturday to battle the Lions from Missouri Southern down in Joplin. Kickoff is scheduled for 2:20 p.m. on the MIAA television network.
Brad, this was definitely a game that would go down in UCM history. The Mules proved time and time again with their backs against the wall to come back against a very good Nebraska-Omaha team. And eventually, your senior quarterback, Eric Cherneski, steps up, finds his favorite target, Jamoris Warren, in the back of the end zone. What a great catch with the two great players hooking up on the play.
Yeah, you got to give a lot of credit to Coach Boda and the staff and the players out on the field. 58 seconds to go, no timeouts. They worked their way down the field, converted a 4th-and-1. Taylor Dyer had a nice catch. You got to give a lot of credit to that staff. Now, like you mentioned, 8-1 overall, 7-0 in the MIAA, and, you know, everything that they wanted from the beginning of the season, their records, their goals, they're in front of them now. Well, it was a good homecoming weekend here at UCM, 3-0 as soccer, volleyball, and the football team wrapped up a great weekend on campus at Central Missouri. Stay tuned next week where we'll have more Mules and Jennies athletics. For DJ Fox and Elgato behind the scenes, I'm Brett Pryor. Thanks for watching Mo Sports.
1, 2, 3,